Heavy snowfall in Minneapolis left cleanup crews quite busy on Wednesday at TCF Bank Stadium, clearing the stands and the field for today's game with Ohio State. It's still snowing and freezing on game day, but Gopher fans wouldn't miss this. A matchup of division leaders in the Big Ten. Ohio State 8th in the college football playoff rankings against number 25 Minnesota. The Buckeyes have yet to lose a regular season conference game under Urban Meyer, and they have the longest active road win streak in the country. But they'll have to deal with frigid temperatures. Short kickoff. Here's Samuel at the 10. And met at the 20 and dropped.
The Minnesota boy.
And no surprise there for the Minnesota quarterback. Barrett is from Texas, and he'll hand it off. Ezekiel Elliott able to break a tackle and a gain of 5 to the 26.
Looks like Trevon Boykin, one of the most improved players in all of college football this year.
He'll throw on second down, flushed out, and completes it to Michael Thomas, short of the marker. So it'll
very good turning the football over.
They've been so good on third down because of Barrett's ability to run the football as well as throw it. There's a flag down. Movement by Ohio State. It'll be third and long.
Full start. Offense. Right side of the line. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
He's in your face, as we saw in that shot on third down and 2. So it's third down and 7 now. Barrett with time. Everybody covered. Barrett breaks a tackle and close to the first down. Cameron Johnston to punt, and that snap was a little bit wide and not a good punt. Minnesota's going to have the ball from the Gopher 38-yard line. Play action for Leidner. Leidner being chased, and he'll throw it away. They did it. They don't want to have to run the ball every first down and 10. Going to hand it off to K.J. May on a jet sweep, and he gets maybe a yard. Football certainly the most underrated. Got 12 career touchdowns as a sophomore. And Leidner looking that way. There's Williams for the catch, but well covered. He'll be short of the first down. Jalen Marshall, the true freshman, taking Dontre Wilson's spot as the punt returner is deep. And this takes a Minnesota hop inside the 10 and down at the 5. And Barrett standing in the goal line. And they pitch it to Marshall. And he's out past the 9 to the 10-yard line. How about that little touch? And they got 6 yards, so second down and 4. They're bringing Marshall in motion again. And hand it off to Elliott. He gets grounded short of the first down by Demarius Travis. So a
third and short situation here.
Here's Barrett finding a hole. Look out. He's past the 25-yard line. Barrett to midfield. Being chased inside the 30. Barrett inside the 20 to the 10. Barrett for the touchdown. What a play by JT Barrett. An 86-yard touchdown run. That's his 9th rushing touchdown, the 35th total touchdown that he has accounted for, only behind Marcus Mariota.
Never know that JT Barrett had that kind of speed, but at 6'1", 225 pounds, he outran the secondary there for Minnesota. Let's go back and take a look at the touchdown. You're going to see the linebacker here. This is Damian Wilson. He's responding to a little bit of a counter action. And once you get JT Barrett past that first level of linebacker, it affects Wilson. And then you come back and you see 8 guys up here at the line of scrimmage. There is nobody back for Minnesota. Third and short situation. If you get past that first line of defense and Wilson misreads it, take a look at the speed from JT Barrett. He's even right there in the secondary and outruns 2 corners for the touchdown. Impressive.
That's the longest play from scrimmage for Ohio State this year. Now the Buckeyes kicking it deep. Here's Jalen Myrick. He has a return for a touchdown this year. And he gets the corner. That tripped up, though. That slowed him down. Still good field position for the Gophers at their 36-yard line. And 2 back on first and 10. And here's Cobb taking it outside. And not much, maybe a yard. Back 1,200-yard campaigns. Leidner to the air, in trouble and slammed down. Joey Bosa with his 11th sack of the year.
They're trying to set up.
270, one of the best players in the Big Ten. Here's Leidner taking off. Has a long way to go on 3rd and 16. He'll come up a few yards short. Von Bell up.
16 after the fact.
Last punt pinned Ohio State to the 5-yard line. Here's Marshall fielding it and paying for it. Dropped around the 12. Logan Hutton for the second straight time. On the Buckeye 13-yard line. And he'll throw it. Being chased, and that takes off and gets good yardage. About 6.
Some numbers, but JT Barrett has been impressive with the way he's improved week in and week out in this offense.
Barrett pitching here to Elliott on second down. Elliott has the first down.
That's where the weaknesses are, and he's getting his team in the right play at the right time.
Elliott passed the 30 to the 32-yard line, so another chunk.
A bit different than Braxton Miller, who had that howitzer.
On second down, Barrett pulls it back, and the ball batted down and complete.
At the second level.
This is a big play, 3rd and 6 with Ohio State having momentum. Barrett, going to throw it on the flat to Elliott. Elliott has the first down as he scampers out of bounds.
Physical nature to this offense, catching the ball is the third thing he can do.
Elliott not much here on the ground. Got one. He's replacing Carlos Hyde, who yards on the ground last week. Ohio State put up 49 points in that game against an excellent defense. Barrett keeping, and he picks up maybe 2, and 4 Gophers flying to the football, led by Snow starting to pick up here. 3rd down and long. Barrett in trouble, gets rid of it, and it's caught. Looses Marshall inside the 20. He'll take it to the house. It's 13-0 Buckeyes. A 57-yard touchdown pass. And just like that, JT Barrett ties the school record for touchdowns responsible for in a year. That's number 36.
And to beat Cedric Thompson for the touchdown.
Well, there was some talk, you know, would this be a letdown game, a morning kickoff after 3 consecutive night games? Ohio State rolling.
Well, and it's Minnesota taking those chances in the secondary. There's nobody left when you bring everybody up, and Ohio State's too powerful to stop.
.200 yards of total offense. This is a Minnesota defense that gives up about 330 per game. Short kickoff. Here's Myrick. And he gets thumped. The ball is free, but out of bounds. It'll be
Cedric Thompson.
On 1st and 10, David Kopp spun down after a gain of 3. He's got him back, but stout getting Clemson into the end zone. Leidner trying to find a running lane. It's not there. Mate. Leidner will throw here on 3rd down, and that is deflected. Incomplete. It didn't seem to matter, though. Ohio State went right down the field on both occasions. Also be interesting to see if Tracy Clay takes any more chances defensively. Another good punt. And this one will kick into the end zone. And Nebraska with the top spot in the West. Huskers and Badgers play today. Barrett on the roll-off completes it. Corey Smith with his 10th catch on the year.
And make it to that Big Ten championship game.
Run play on 2nd and 8. Another big hole for Elliott. Past the 40 and slammed down at the 44 as Ohio State now just gashing Minnesota's defense.
Total match, but they have gotten so much better as this season has gone on.
Barrett with a ton of time, going to air it out. His deep ball is picked off inside the 10-yard line by Body Calhoun. And he gets a block past the 20. Body Calhoun past the 40, breaks a tackle, still going, and finally down. A huge turnover for the Gophers. It's their 13th pick of the year, their 2nd of the Big Ten in that category. Bring a 58-yard return. Now Cobb on 1st down, wrapped up, breaks a tackle. Bosa Tackles him forward to the 35. Max Williams out into the slot. Second down and six. Cobb, big hole, breaks another tackle and gets the first down. That's an 11-yard hard run.
Minnesota offense.
Now can the Gophers capitalize on getting inside the 25? Cobb again. Close to another first down. ESPN on ABC College Football presented by Kate Jewelers will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations. The 1940, second down and one. They'll keep it on the ground, and Cobb has the first down, pushes the pile to the five. Back again with Thomas as the fullback. Cobb again. Said before the break, hey, let's keep going, keep giving it to me. And that's touchdown number nine on the season for David Cobb.
And we talked about the offensive line starting to exert themselves. Let's give some credit to Max Williams, too. We talk a lot about him.
39 of Ohio State. And in five plays in less than 2 minutes, all David Cobb. 15 degrees, the coldest game that Ohio State has played since 1960. Now the Buckeyes take over on their 25-yard line. See how Barrett responds after throwing a pick. Ezekiel Elliott, and a beautiful tackle in the open field by Cedric Thompson.
The perimeter with our defensive secondary.
Barrett out of an empty set, low pass, and it's a catch at the 27. But Barrett facing a four-man rush. His pass is incomplete behind Heuermann. He would not have had the first down on the catch anyway, and the Buckeyes have to punt. There's the true freshman as the deep man for the Gophers. And a high snap, but it's pulled down and a kick away. Minnesota does have two blocked punts this year and in a lot of traffic. Five white jerseys, 55-yard line. Cobb again. And this time Ohio State gang tackles, a one-yard pickup. Cobb again, and there's Joey Bosa. He missed him on the touchdown, but not that time. That's already a tackle for a loss.
And it's a big game like this against Ohio State.
Play action for Leidner. Deep pass is incomplete. And more first down, so you're keeping Ohio State's offense cold and on the bench. Another good punt by Mortel. Marshall backing up. He muffs it, scoops it up at the five. He's in trouble, and he breaks a tackle. Finally goes down inside the five. And DB's coach. Now, Ohio State backed up for the second time inside its five. Here's Elliott, and he stood up, but then able to muscle.
Still feel it the entire game.
Here comes second down. There's that little shovel pass on the end around to Marshall, who's got the first down. Oh, he hurdles two guys and is out to the 27-yard line.
Yards downfield.
We talked earlier about the touch pass. That avoids, if the ball hits the ground, it being a fumble and be a forward pass. Here's a design quarterback run for Barrett. And Barrett slides for about a yard.
It's Minnesota team that also played TCU. TCU beat them 30-7 earlier in the year.
Barrett and wide open, but dropped. Michael Thomas.
Zero coverage. Again, no safety in the middle of the field. Aggressive from Tracy Clay.
Everybody in the box. Barrett fakes the pitch and runs, and here we go again. Barrett breaking a tackle at midfield. Inside the 40 and out of bounds at the 34. So another 15 yards. 141 yards on the ground already for Barrett. He'll throw it here and fires, and a beautiful catch. Nick Vanette adjusting in midair. 64% completion rate on the year for Barrett. Barrett keeping here inside the 15 and dragged down around the 7-yard line by Cedric Thompson. So the Buckeyes are inside the 10.
You're inside the 10 going in.
And here's Marshall inside the five. Fumble the ball. Loose in the end zone. Still loose. And the Gophers recover. It'll be a touchback. Devondre Campbell recovers. recovers the fumble. It looked like Marshall would score. Instead, he coughs it up. Second turnover by Ohio State.
Looked like he was trying to reach that ball out. Young players, especially freshmen like Jaden Marshall, will try to score, reach that football out. Great hit there. No, he didn't try to reach it out. That was just a great hit on the ball by Boddy Calhoun. Ball comes out.
Evan Spencer had a chance to recover for a touchdown. He couldn't fall on it. Yeah, Boddy Calhoun in there on the hit.
And that part of it is the elements, too, right? The elements securing the football when it gets cold.
And they have the ball back on the 20. Here's Cobb, and he runs through two defenders. Oh, man, he was off to the races if Von Bell didn't get him to the ground at the 31-yard line.
Well, there's a lot of great backs in the Big Ten. Not a whole lot of people talking about David Cobb.
Here he is again. And good pickup near the 35-yard line.
He's done a lot of this heavy lifting on his own.
Second and seven. Cobb again breaks tackles near the first down. He'll come up just short.
That's weird.
10 of the last 11 plays have been Cobb runs. Here's third and one. Cobb again got the first down. He got tagged at the 43 pretty good by Josh Perry, but it's a down run by Cobb. A fresh set now at the 42. Here's play action. Leidner with time going for Max Williams. There was contact and a flag. Von Bell ran into Williams.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 11. 15-yard penalty. Results in an automatic first down.
It's 5'11", 200 pounds.
They've only given up 7 points. They've had trouble stopping Cobb between the tackles. Here's K.J. May getting the corner at the 35. Near another first down.
Danger Ohio State's going to be in.
First thing he said when he got on the call with us was, Minnesota's a top 25 team. Here's Cobb. Great play by Michael Bennett.
Some depth and rotation on that defensive line.
Play action for Leidner. Rolling out and throwing for Williams. Knocked away by Bell. Incomplete. Fourth down. Play fake. Leidner caught. First down. The fullback. Thomas inside the 30-yard line. And Leidner says, yep. Pull two for his coach to call his number to throw it. Here's Cobb. And he's in trouble. There's a flag down as well, likely a hold. Von Bell on the tackle. And the flag was thrown right at an Ohio State player who had a Gopher on top of him.
I think they're going to get Josh Campion, the left tackle, for tackling.
Holding offense, number 65. 10-yard penalty. Replay, first down.
Stretch, not trying to take down the Buckeyes. Here's Leidner. And another good play by Bell. Sure tackler for Ohio State. Closing in on 2 minutes to go here in the half. They're going to run it. And Cobb goes nowhere. On Tom Luganville. He's made a 52-yarder. And they're going to run Cobb here. Cobb breaks a tackle. We're going to have more than three here. It's a touchdown for Cobb. Senior, and the Gophers now with a chance to tie the game. Well, Ohio State has scored on third down a couple of times. Now it's Minnesota's turn on third and 15.
It's Tyvis Powell missing the secondary.
And Santoso evens the game at 14 apiece.
It's about the team with David Cobb. That's really cool to see.
Taking it out. Samuel, he broke a tackle. Another one past the 30. And Ohio State in business with a minute 16 on the clock. They're going to have the ball near their own 40-yard line. Ohio State has two timeouts remaining. Barrett looking. And a pass caught by Michael Thomas, a gain of about six.
No safety again for Minnesota defensively.
That has not worked well. Barrett going deep. Overthrown. Tried to hit Devin Smith. Ohio State with a minute to go in the half. And Barrett will keep it. get the first down and to go for territory at the 47-yard line.
The best success has been with Barrett running.
Barrett is going to throw, though. Wide open was Heuermann, and Barrett was high with the throw. Eight in the box. And another pass play. And Barrett's pass incomplete. Evan Smith near midfield. Barrett will run it again. And he's got the first down inside the 40. But a goodness is long. First and 10 Buckeyes. And Barrett back to throw again, in trouble. And Barrett finds a receiver, but it's knocked down at the last second. The play clock is down to three. Another pass. Barrett looking deep. Pass is underthrown. Incomplete, but a flag. Eric Murphy interfered with Michael Thomas.
Pass interference, defense, number 31. 15-yard penalty.
Every single week we talk about it, Dave. If you don't turn your head as a defensive back and look for the football, then you're going to put yourself at risk. It gets the left hand on the shoulder, and if you're not looking back, they're going to call that every single time. And Eric Murray, I'm surprised. On film, as I've watched him this year, I haven't seen that.
So that puts the ball at the 21-yard line of Minnesota. 15 seconds remaining and one timeout for Ohio State. Barrett. With time, going to the end zone, and it is broken up at the last second again. We're on the near hash mark right now. And Barrett gonna throw. Dumps it off to Elliott inside the 15. And close to a first down. There's 2 seconds left and now a flag. So a penalty flag that will put the ball around the 5. And now if you're Urban Meyer, you have a decision to make. You got 2 seconds left. Do you take the points or do you say, you know what, we're going to try for a touchdown?
After runner was out of bounds, personal foul, late hit, number 41. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Because it's... Nurnberger puts it through and gives the Buckeyes the lead at halftime. Minnesota will get the football to start the second half. Ohio State trying to keep its playoff hopes alive with a 3-point lead. It's snowing.
Yes.
By the way, David Cobb, tremendous first half for Minnesota. 96 rushing yards and 2 scores. And the Gophers will get the ball to start the second half. A little trickery. They throw it back to Myrick. Myrick passed the 30. Can't stay in bounds. Kyle, he made the play. So now Minnesota with good starting field position. Cobb on first down is bottled up. Joey Bosa. The field goal is time expired. They take a 3-point lead. Leidner. And that was tipped. And it's in third long, although they ran for a touchdown in third and 15. Leidner to the air. Has time. And the receiver fell down. It's picked off by Grant. Duran Grant taking it back the other way. It's an Ohio State touchdown. But there is a penalty flag down back at midfield where the ball was thrown. Will this be interference and a first down for Minnesota, taking a touchdown off the board for Ohio State?
Pass interference, defense, number 12, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Isaac Frickte, the receiver who was... in the area, Duran Grant on the cover.
It looked like he fell down. Frickte goes down right there, and Duran Grant, I don't know, that could have gone either way. If Frickte was going down on his own, Grant had his hands on him, but I wouldn't be surprised if that flag wasn't thrown. I wouldn't have an argument.
How about that? So you go from a touchdown to Minnesota converting in third and long, and now they have the ball in Ohio State territory.
Huge call.
Leidner, big hole. And he's able to move the pile to the 40-yard line to get the first down. First time since 2008. Trying to get there again this year. Roll off for Leidner. Looking deep. Got a man overthrown. KJ May had it. But a pass just past his fingertips. Get third and two running the football. That's why they took the shot there. But it's another pass. And it's caught. First down inside the 35. It's Isaac Frickte. Not a heavy dose of Cobb yet for the Gophers. Here it comes. And Bosa got a hold of Cobb. But he won't go down. Stood up at the 32.
He's 40. That's amazing.
Play action. Leidner in trouble, and he goes down. A sack at the 35-yard line. And run the ball to try to give their kicker a chance to tie it. It is a quarterback run, and Leidner goes nowhere. Ohio State all over that play, so no gain. Michael Bennett there first, and now it's a 52-yard field goal try for these conditions before. A 52-yarder. And the wind blows it off the upright. That thing was curving back. Looked like it might end up splitting the uprights. Instead, it's no good in Ohio. But Santoso's 52-yard field goal hits the upright. Now, he drilled this thing about halfway up that left upright.
Take a look at my man down here. You think he's not hoping that thing goes in? Ball boy.
It started left, and it began to hook back like it might make it between the uprights, but no good. And Ohio State will start on its 35-yard line. First possession of the second half of the Buckeye offense. And Ezekiel Elliott with a big run. Got about eight before he's dragged down by Eric Murray.
On the perimeter. And guys, another thing with JT Barrett, we see him here. You don't realize how big and physical he is as a runner.
Run that ball in between the tackles, and they have a man and a half advantage in the blocking scheme, and it's hard to get JT Barrett on the ground at 225 pounds.
Here's Marshall off the right side, and he's got the first down to the 41.
And looks rattled with that defense, but he has come back in a big way.
Barrett gets outside, again showing the speed, tripped up around the first down marker at the 31. Elliott, and he's grounded after a short gain.
35 seconds, and he came back up.
Show some toughness for an Arizona guy. Oh, Barrett's got a man wide open. An easy touchdown for Michael Thomas. Blown coverage by the Gophers. And Thomas, who wasn't wearing sleeves in the first half because he's from California, put him on the second half. And a 30-yard touchdown.
We see Derek Wells and Eric Murray. Eric Murray thought he had help behind. A miscommunication there in the secondary, which is not normal for this Minnesota team. Their most experienced part of their team is in that secondary, and a blown coverage gives up 7 points.
And that is a new school record for touchdowns responsible for. JT Barrett, in just 9.5 games, responsible for 37 touchdowns. And he's the nation's leader in that category, along with Marcus Mariota.
Ohio State all bunched up in the middle of the field.
Taken at the 5-yard line. Myrick, and he's drilled at the 20, and a penalty flag, which is likely against Minnesota.
Illegal block in the back, receiving team number 81, 10-yard penalty. First.
Buckeyes hoping to represent the East in the Big Ten championship game. Minnesota hoping to do the same for the West. And here's Leidner on the run, and he's up to the 15-yard line.
And then on the road to Nebraska and Wisconsin, but I think people watching this game understand this is a good football team.
Got a whistle and movement by Minnesota. Hurting themselves here in the second half.
Offense, number 85, 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
One of those teams just jumps out at you and says they're much better than the other. But it'll be interesting to see who comes out of the West.
Only the third carry for Cobb this half. And, well, here comes a flag. That looked like a face mask as Cobb was taken down. Darren Lee stuck his hand in there. And that'll be a 15-yard penalty and a first down.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 43. 15-yard penalty results in an automatic first down.
Yeah, when you turn the mask, you're going to get flack.
That's just to be reckoned with.
Well, you know they're going to recruit at Ohio State. Done a good job so far. Leidner in trouble, and he gets walloped back inside the 20. Donnell Kirkwood is in the game, and he'll get a carry here and breaks a tackle, gets away from another defender to the 30-yard line, so he got 12 of it back. It'll
number one ranked linebacker last year in the ESPN 300 and Under Armour All-American.
That was Luke Fickell, the defensive coordinator, as Leidner throws deep, going for Max Williams. Williams juggled it and hung on. First down, Gophers. The big tight end finally comes through when Minnesota needed a play. Here's Cobb. Try to find a hole. It's not there. Slam down. Adolphus, Washington, and Bosa.
In the running game.
Here comes a reverse. Now May looking to pass, and he's brought down for a loss at the 41 by Darren Lee. Now they're out of field goal range. 2 yards to give him another shot. But they're going to pass. Leidner over the middle. High and picked off. Intercepted at the 20-yard line. It's Duran Grant. Grant brings it back to the 44. Excellent starting field position at the Ohio State 45. And a fumble on the play. Barrett jumps back on it.
25-6.
Here at second down and 12 for the Buckeyes. The late pitch to Elliott, and he breaks tackles. Elliott finally brought down near midfield by Damian Wilson.
Zero coverage again from Minnesota.
They bring Marshall into the backfield. They fake the pitch. Barrett wrapped up and tackle. Gain of two, fourth down.
The same aggressive style. For us to get the numbers on the quarterback run game, we've got to play zero coverage.
Cameron Johnston has not had a good day punting the football. This isn't bad. Could have been a lot worse for Minnesota. Fair on the final four. First down for the Golden Gophers. Just shy of their 20-yard line. Here's Cobb through a hole. And Cobb wrapped up near the first down. They'll keep it here with Leidner, and he's able to move the sticks. Got the first down to the 29-yard line.
Four guys that play just about every snap on defense. How will they fare in the fourth quarter?
Here's Cobb. Finds a crease. An ankle tackle past the 35 by Darren Lee. Been a lot. 8 yards there. So a second down and two. And Cobb this time stood up. Forward progress will put him right at the first down marker here. And it will be Leidner. They get some help, but a flag down. Max Williams came in there.
Illegal formation on the offense. 5 men in the backfield. 5-yard penalty. Replay, third down.
And Jerry Kill knows that that's a penalty you just can't have in this situation.
And that's a killer.
Now they spread it out here on third down at 6. Leidner rolling to his right. And looking into traffic, it's intercepted again, this time by Von Bell. And Bell is to the Minnesota 30. Back-to-back picks thrown by Leidner. And Ohio State will take over deep in Minnesota territory.
Well, and it's
not where Minnesota's successful. Not many teams are. Elliott met at the point of attack and dropped. Minimal gain there. Jacklin 32-3 with the losses. Virginia Tech out of conference. Michigan State in the Big Ten Championship and Clemson in the bowl game. Elliott rumbles to the 26. Congratulations by the previous staff under Jim Tressel. Third down and 4. Barrett little roll to the left and the catch made by Marshall for a first down. Spun out of play. 10 straight points by the Buckeyes after Minnesota tied it late in the first half. Barrett pulls it back and throws high. They just have thrown it away that time. Seeing the way he just kind of fell asleep.
It's the details.
On second down, they run an end around, and Corey Smith is tackled for a loss by Jack Lynn. That is a...
Wouldn't be surprised they did it again here.
Oh, it's third and 12. See if they do it. Going to be a pass. Barrett trying to set up a wide receiver screen. Look out. It's going to be a touchdown. Well designed as Evan Spencer takes it in and maybe puts away the Gophers. What a great design on third and 12. A 22-yard touchdown pass. The third today for Barrett.
Great call by Tom Herman, the offensive coordinator. They've got the blitz off the edge. You get the block by Vanette. Get the ball in the hands of Evan Spencer, and you know you're going to have zero coverage. There's nobody left. Perfect call for Ohio State.
Nurnberger on for the extra point. And that's 17 straight. Ohio State is 30 by Troy Smith in 2006. And there's still 2 regular season games left. That kick goes out of bounds, so good field position for Minnesota. How do they have to throw it here? They'll keep it on the ground on first down. David Cobb wrestled to the ground by Adolphus Washington for no gain. Our college football playoff rankings brought to you by Vizio.
Beat Minnesota 30-7 is naturally going to be compared with how this game finally ends up in the win column for Ohio State.
Cobb, beautiful cutback, got the first down to the 46-yard line. On first down, going to be a play. Pass, and Leitner rolling out. Look out, almost threw another pick, diving attempt by Apple.
To help Ohio State continue to climb.
Well, yeah, Tom, they could lose to the Florida Gators if they don't lose tonight as well. Florida Gators are looking better. They're playing South Carolina today, so.
Remember, not the best teams for the whole season. And that's how they're going to evaluate it as that pass is overthrown. They have to.
That comparison might come into play for the College Football Playoff Committee.
There's the punt, and the fair catch is muffed, and Minnesota recovers at the 14. Miles Thomas recovered, as that's a sort of score. The Gophers have been shut out by this Ohio State defense here in the second half. Here's Cobb. And there just hasn't been a lot of running room for him.
And to come down,
went there a long time there in the huddle as well, and wasting precious seconds here as we close in on 7 minutes to go. Cobb again through a crease, and he's in for the Minnesota touchdown. Third one today for David Cobb. Cobb doing what he can to keep the Gophers' hopes alive on his final home game as a Gopher. 3 rushing touchdowns, 11 on the year. Santoso for the point after. Now it comes down to whether Minnesota can get a stop. 2 possession game, 10-point lead for Ohio State. Jalen Marshall has had his trouble. Put the ball on the ground 3 times. Meanwhile, David Cobb has found the end zone 3 times. Everybody around. Instead, it's going to be a kick deep. Curtis Samuel from the 5-yard line. And Samuel makes it to the 20, and that's it. The end of the first half. That's big. That can be a 1 possession game right now with 7 minutes left. As it is, Ohio State by 10, and here's Barrett. Saw something, a big gap in the middle of the defense, and he takes it to the 27 as he was going into score. 2nd and 3. And Elliott, close to the first down, should have it at the 30. Going to get them to the next level. They know what they did wrong when they make mistakes. Here's Barrett, and he gets tackled for a short gain. Derek Wells trying to strip the ball, could not. Couple more first downs, game might be over. And here's Elliott up to the 35. They got 5 percentage. They're right around 80% today. 3rd down and 5. Barrett on the run. And he tries to cut it back, breaks a tackle, and gets the first down. And with 3.5 to go, again, a couple more first downs. Game could be over. Here's Elliott, and he gets the first down for Ohio State.
Miller's going to be the guy. And then, you know, on that fateful day in August at preseason camp, Braxton Miller goes down, and all of a sudden, as you see Ezekiel Elliott up the middle, all of a sudden, JT.
Trying to close out the Gophers. Inside 3 minutes to go, leading by 10. 2nd down and 5. Quarterback run all the way for Barrett, and he's met by Campbell in the hole. He gets to the 42.
What is Urban Meyer going to do? I think that's on everybody's mind in Columbus.
Barrett on 3rd down and 3. Hit by Campbell and taken down.
Where you have Braxton Miller, who just was growing in that process, but still was just a playmaker.
Punt sails into the end zone. It'll be a touchback. Minnesota needs 10 points with 2.
When JT Barrett had adversity, right? As you see this pass to Max Williams, the outside, there was adversity.
Down, too. Leitner. And pass on the money to Frickte for a first down. 2:16 remaining. Leitner stepping up and looking for the sideline. Can he get there? No. Clock will continue to run. 10 seconds tick off the clock. Now on 2nd down and short. Dropped. There's some movement there. Flag down. Zach Epping, the left guard, moved. That's why
Ball
Ohio State was into the
offense,
neutral zone.
Number 52, 5-yard penalty.
Leitner on 3rd down and 6. And Frickte able to make the catch. He came back, looked like he had the first down initially, then was pushed back. He did get out of bounds and got the first down. Leidner into traffic, knocked down by Von Bell.
Kind of carved him up a little bit, and this today Cobb did as well.
Leidner running, and he's got room inside the 30. Leidner inside the 20. We'll stop the clock to get the chain gang down there to the 17-yard line. One must spike the ball. And how do you handle this? You're in a situation where it's about a 35, 40-yard field goal. Would Santoso, will he get a chance here for a 33-yard field goal? Try to make it a one-possession game. And the kick is good. And Minnesota's not done. Can they recover an onside kick? And on the Ohio State sideline for 79 more seconds. Andrew Hart lining up to kick it. And he kicks it straight ahead, and it's an easy recovery for Ohio State. That was the case. I don't think the players did. I don't think the coaches did. I think Minnesota is just a good football team.
Yeah. The game that David Cobb had here, you know, and Cobb and Wilson are cousins playing in the last game here. Emotional leaders, been a big part of Jerry Kill turning this program around. They can go out with their head held high with the way they played in this game.
Ohio State 9-1, 6-0 in the Big Ten. The Buckeyes play their final two regular season games at home. They have Indiana, then Michigan. That's now 22 consecutive regular season Big Ten victories for Ohio State, going back to the loss against Michigan in 2011. As David Cobb leaves this stadium for the last time, but the Gophers have at least three games left. Two in the regular season at Nebraska, at Wisconsin, a bowl game for sure, but also still an outside chance at playing in the Big Ten Championship, because if they beat Nebraska and Wisconsin, they'll have a chance depending on how the tiebreakers play out.